Hi everyone, and welcome back to the last parts of Lesson 9, Level 3. We just got done talking about shipping issues, but now that we have that sorted out, it's time to move on to another tool that we can use to find an optimal answer to a pretty complex problem. The problem is called an assignment problem. I'm going to introduce you to a new type of constraint called a binary constraint. In order to use a binary constraint, I need a case where I need a series of yes or no or boolean or binary answers. Let's say that I'm a real estate developer and I'm building a new subdivision in my neighborhood and have four different contracts that I need to award in order to get the neighborhood built. I'm going to need someone to demolish an existing building and level the surrounding area, saving the trees, of course. I'll also need someone to run the water main through the neighborhood. Contract 3 will run the sewer lines, and Contract 4 will be to build an awesome swimming pool. I've asked four different general contracting companies to submit bids for these four different contracts. Zushin General Contractors, Armstrong Contracting, Big Bob's Big Trucks and Other Big Stuff, and finally Contractors R Us. I'm thinking Big Bob should hire a marketing firm to come up with a better name. What do you think? I want all four of these companies to remain friendly to me in the future, so I've told them all that they will each get one of the four contracts. Just submit to me your proposal price for each of the four contracts, and I'll put them in this awesome spreadsheet and figure out the best one for everybody. These numbers here are the bid prices from each of the four contractors for each of the four contracts. It's now our job to figure out which contract to award to which contractor in order to minimize my costs for this development. If I were to manually try to figure out the best option, I might do an awesome rank function like we did in modules 2 and 4 in here and give the contract to each rank of 1, or I could do a conditional formatting here and give it to the greenest one of each column. The rank function would probably be better, but I'm feeling colorful today. Let me do some conditional formatting here in this first column, and once I get that working, then I'll use the formatting painter to copy that formatting here, and then to here, and again to here. It looks like contract 1 is going to go to the contractors RS, so I'll put a 1 over here. Big Bob is the greenest for the water lines and the sewer lines, so Big Bob gets 1s here and here. Zeus is the cheapest for the pool, so he gets a 1 here. I could put all zeros in all these other cells, but it doesn't serve much purpose at this point, so I think I'll pass on that. Just keep in mind for each of these cells over here, ultimately there's going to be either a 0 if it's not awarded and a 1 if it is awarded. So how much does this contract allotment combination cost me? We could just hold the control key down and select the greenest cells. Boom, 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 boom. And down here it says $489,000, but what's the fun in that? Instead, let's do some math out here. If we remember our awesome sum product formula from Lesson 8, we can do that over here in column K. Equals sum product. These prices over here in this array of cells, and then a comma. Then this array of cells here, which is the number of contracts that are awarded. Close out our parentheses. Copy that down, come down here, and I'll do an alt plus the equal sign, and ta-da, we get 489,000. I know that's a little anticlimactic now, since we already knew the answer, but what the heck. Formulas are where it's at, right? We could also show off our increasingly vast knowledge of the sum product formula and our arrays, and in this cell down here, put in a sum product formula that references this whole group of cells. So that's an array, comma, and then multiply and add times this array, which is all of our zeros and ones. I kind of like that, so let's leave that one. We do have a little bit of a problem here in our first attempt, though. Big Bob has two contracts, and I promised these four contractors that they would each get a single contract. I could start randomly putting ones and zeros all over the place to come up with hopefully the best possible solution, but that could take thousands of hours. I'm already in my 50s, so that ain't gonna happen. Let's set up our solver model optimally to find this answer for us. I'll go up to the data ribbon and select solver. Now set our objective cell to K7, and that's our ultimate cost cell. Since it is a cost that I want to minimize, I set it to min. Next, my changing cells are these cells here where all the zeros and ones are going to go. Since I know that all I want out here in these changing cells is zeros and ones, I'm going to add a constraint that forces all of those cells into either, go figure, a zero or one. That mode is called binary. For the cell reference, I'll highlight all of these cells up here again, and then in the second field, I'll add bin, which then thankfully puts binary over here for me. Don't ever try typing binary over here, as life will get pretty difficult with you and you'll break your solver model. Also, while I'm here, and this is a simple problem that doesn't require all the overthinking and brain power of a nonlinear algebra, I'll set this parameter to simplex. Let me hit solve, and we get nothing, all zeros. Since we told it to minimize our answer, it just again told us that zero is the minimum, so it puts zero everywhere. In order to improve on this situation, I need to make sure that my model satisfies all of my needs. I want the optimal answer, and I want to make sure that all the contracts are awarded appropriately. In order to keep things straight in my mind, I'm going to add one constraint at a time over here on our constraints table. First, let me add that binary constraint that we did just a minute ago to this table, and that helps me keep track of what all's going on. Now I want to make sure that each contract is actually awarded to somebody. I can do that if I create a sum formula down here, referencing the cells immediately above it, and then copying it across. So if each of these cells here in this totals row are equal to 1, then each contract gets awarded one time, right? In our solver constraints table, I'll document the fact that we want a constraint for each of these cells, and I want to force a value of 1. Now let me go into our solver model and add that constraint. Solver, add a constraint, cell reference of F7 through I7 equals this cell over here, C12. That contains our value of 1. Hit OK, solve, and now at least we get back to where we were a few minutes ago, and the model's now automatically coming up with that $489,000 on its own. However, we still have the problem that we had before with Big Bob being awarded 2 contracts. I'm betting that we need another constraint. Let me close this. In order to make sure that each contractor only gets 1 contract, I'm going to come up here into this column, into column J, and add the formula in J3 that sums up the number of contracts that Zeus gets awarded. Let me copy this down. Now, if each of these is 1, that means that each contractor gets awarded 1 and only 1 contract. That sounds like a constraint to me that looks like this. J3 through J6 equals 1. Let me go up here and make it happen. Launch solver. Add a constraint. The cell reference of J3 through J6. Equals cell C13. Hit OK and solve. And there we have the correct answer. Let me generate the answer report to prove that all of my constraints are optimally satisfied. Let me look in the answer report, look at these constraints. Yep. So, our quest to keep all of our contracting partners in business and happy costs us $514,000, minus the optimal answer that was generated earlier of $489,000. That sounds like a $25,000 business decision that I'm happy with. So that's it for now. In the next video, we'll show you how to handle it if we have more contractors than we do contracts to award. All right, go Knowles!